Hey everyone, welcome to another objective review. Today, we are going to be taking a look at Scanner Pro by Riddle. Riddle recently launched version 7 of Scanner Pro, which brings interesting features like OCR scanning as well as workflow automation. We'll talk about the workflow automation in a bit. What OCR scanning is that when you scan a document with Scanner Pro, it can detect the text in that scan and make it readily copyable in a way that you can copy the text from the scan and take it to some other app, like perhaps email, or if you're writing an article, you can take it to that app as well. Scanner Pro also allows you to use its radar feature, wherein it can kind of detect pretty accurately all the documents that you have already in your camera roll and import them into the app, so it can do all its distortion correcting magic on it and give you scanned copies of those documents per se. You can then share these scanned copies across a variety of apps, which also includes a couple of their own, including Documents, PDF Expert, Printer Pro, as well as invoking the native share sheet of iOS. You can select any scanned item and go ahead and add it to a folder or share it using the Scanner Pro share dialog, or you can go into Edit to run it through distortion correction, OCR, document size management, so on and so forth. Now, Scanner Pro comes with a predefined list of custom sizes that are already used, for example, like A4 or a letter size and so on. But you can also use a custom crop or a crop to fit option, and the scanned copy will be the exact size that it needs to be. Whenever you're viewing an item or a collection of items, and if you tap on the add button, you can add more items to this collection itself and they will all group up when you're back on the home screen. Workflows is another new feature introduced in Scanner Pro version 7. Now, I'm still not completely sold on this as it is quite limited at the moment of making this review, but I hope Riddle improves the workflows and allows inter-app communication within the workflow itself. As for creating new workflows, managing existing ones or deleting them is as straightforward as you'd expect them to be. Creating a new workflow gives you a list of actions that you can take for when processing a particular item, like renaming the item or saving it to your photos. Keep in mind that when you're saving it to your photos, it is going to be saved as an image and not as a PDF. You can further add actions like saving the image or PDF file to Dropbox, Google Drive, Box, OneDrive, or to your own custom servers, or set it to Evernote or OneNote, or all of these at the same time, followed by saving it to a folder within Scanner Pro. And finally, you can delete it if you don't need it, or not delete it and keep it as is. To use these workflows, when you're viewing an item, simply tap on the share button. Towards the bottom, you'll see a list of all your workflows that you've created, and starting them is as simple as tapping on one of the workflows. Now, if the app fails at any point, it'll just stop right there without proceeding any further. But if it succeeds, it'll checkmark each and every action that it completes as it goes. When you're on the home screen, you can pull the list of documents a little down to show the actions of sorting the documents by name or date, or searching through them, or adding a new folder. Now, folders is a great way to organize your scanned documents. I personally use it to organize my documents in basically two steps. One is all my receipts, and the other one is just general the scanned documents. Scanner Pro 7 has also added support for 3D touch for folders as well as individual items. When you 3D touch a folder, it just shows you all the contents towards the top of that folder, and when you 3D touch on an item, it gives you a general preview of the item. In both cases, if you swipe up when using 3D touch, Scanner Pro exposes a list of actions that you can take for that given folder or the item. The settings section in Scanner Pro is mostly personalizing the app to fit your needs. Now, remember one thing, that if you're using any of the third-party services like Dropbox or Box or Google Drive, you should add these under the cloud services option inside settings first, and then create the associated workflows. I would also recommend turning on the text recognition, aka OCR feature, which comes really, really handy when you're scanning large documents and you need to quickly email them as text. I've been using Scanner Pro for over a year now, and I really can't recommend any other app similar to it. Now, Scanner Pro is available on the App Store for just $3, and I would strongly recommend you get it if a lot of your work involves handling documents, especially given that tomorrow is Earth Day. So, hey, go paperless. Well, like this video if you liked it. If you disliked it, you know what to do. Leave a comment down below. And if you're new to the channel, don't forget to subscribe. I'll see you next time. Cheers.